Okay, Mr. Bobo, please take your time.
Okay, thank you so much. Call me.
You're welcome.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
First of all, let's pray and thank to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given us some mercies and blessings, so we can attend and gathering in this Zoom meeting in good condition and happy situation. Salawat and greetings we deliver to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How are you, ladies and gentlemen? Good evening. It's so wonderful and precious for me to be your master of ceremony of our weekly Zoom meeting today. My name is Sofyan. I was born and raised in Mage, Batomarafajoram, and I live in Bali. So our agenda tonight as follows is, number one, there's opening by MC, which is myself. And then number two is presentation by Alfie Yanti. She's from Pekan Baru and she's here already. Number three is question and answer session. Then the last one is closing by Alfie. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the main event. Please welcome Alfie Yanti. Alfie Yanti, the stage is yours. Okay, please, Alfie Yanti, take your time.
All right. I want to share first my presentation.
Yeah, LVNT already sent your share screen, so you may use this slide. Yeah.
Have I?
Yeah. No, I already sent a share screen for you, LVNT. So you now you can start the presentation. Can you see the slide?
Right.
Yep.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. You may start right now.
Okay. I have any material to explaining Mr. Helmi. I have something to explain. With my topic.
Yeah, this one.
Can I give the other material, Mr. Hami?
Okay, this is your material, right? You want to change the other one?
Yes, I have another.
Okay. Okay, so I just stop the screen and then you may share screen by yourself, right? Okay, please all take right. The time. Okay.
Okay, this is my presentation about my school. First of all, I would like to say thank you very much to Allah who has given me a chance to have the opportunity to getting together in here with our participant, members participating here. So I am very happy to have the opportunity today because the last time I have a terrible busy, right? I postponed until twice I spoke to give the presentation in this moment. So I would like to, I only have to give what I'm doing, my daily activity during my daily activity during the school, yeah. So this year, my school is SMK, yeah, Muhammadiyah 2 Pekanbaru, Jalan Kiai Haji Ahmad Dahlan, yeah. Anybody knows here, Jalan Kiai Haji Ahmad Dahlan?
Yeah, I'm quite familiar with this place.
All right. Okay. Okay, before we start, maybe we have a culture to use work culture, yeah, budaya kerja.
Excuse me, Al, would you like to make a slideshow, please, to make it bigger so everybody can see very well about your slide? Can you make it to slideshow? Yeah. You back to the slide and but post the slideshow.
But this is a slideshow, you know?
Oh, yeah? Okay. You may continue?
Yeah.
Yep. Okay. Slideshow, well okay. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah, we may we use five areas: ringkas, seton, rapi, seresik, sekesurawat, and sekesurajin. Yeah, because it is a vocational school, right? All right. So this is my name is Alfianti SPD. Yeah. Sarjana education. Okay, this is my school actually. This is before, yeah. This is my school. It is it is a complex one. We have three school in here. In here is my school, vocational school. At the middle is senior school. And then the back is junior school. Now for this is Winsuskaya. And then in the left is Muhammadiyah, yeah, the gedung building of Muhammadiyah. You know, nowadays is school. It's a complex one, okay, this is student, yeah, or my student picture. Getting together, you know, my student in here is like to have get me picture or this because they are in multimedia, right? Multimedia is a complete with a photographer, you know. And it is a laboratory. It is about the cafe. Yeah. The cafe is design communication visual. It is the new laboratory for this is open in this year. Yeah. It is about we will having about the advertisement maybe later on for the advertisement. This is a pusat pembelajaran ya, teaching factory. It is for business ya, for business classroom. How to make the study retail study? How to be a salesman? This is another program about the cafe. The student study photographer, it is about the laboratory. Then the other is, this is a kind of classroom, right? classroom. This is in the first floor, the student is getting together. Congregation prayer in here in the first floor, and then there are many classes in this first floor too, and then in the second floor. The classes only in the first floor, the second floor, and only the sixth floor. But in Integral ones, actually, it is only the office, right? As you can see here, it is the tallest one. It is the first floor. It is the office all. The top of the office is the headmaster, and then the second floor is the vice headmaster, and then the third floor is library, and then the second floor is for the teacher room, and then the first floor is for basement, right? Okay, this is a kind of a classroom, the classroom for the student. This classroom is so many, this is a, maybe it is a room, maybe it is the building A, maybe the behind, maybe behind of this building is a building B, maybe this side in here, beside here is a building C, and then the outside is maybe the building D, and maybe the other side in the back is behind D. Maybe we have around 40 room, yeah. We have 40 room, then we have maybe the student for 1,000 student, yeah. 1,000, yeah. 1,000 student. It is a student laboratory for accountant, right? And the next one is this is a teacher room, the room for the teacher, because in empty because we have come back home for home when I take the picture. And this is an aula. Aula is for the meeting room for the student and for the teacher. And maybe we have getting some meeting in here, student and the teacher, and we're always somebody else or from the guest. This is a teacher meeting room. We are coming here if we have a meeting, maybe once a month we have a meeting with all of the teachers here and employers and the headmaster and then the headmaster. Yeah. You know, this is my big house. It is about my family. Yeah. This is a big house. And, you know, I've been here in Tapikamang, right? I was born here. I was born here, but I grew up in here. I grew up in here. This is my new house. And then in the back of this house is my old house too. So I have moved three houses in Magi, right? Okay, this is my daughter. Yeah, this is my daughter and me as mother. And now this is a late father. Yeah, late father is working offices. Yeah, offices working the last times. Or the railing company. Yeah, this is one late father. Yeah, among foreigner. Yeah, this is what they do. This is about oil in offices. What they are doing while they are working. This is a new building school. In new building school, it is near of my where I'm living in now. But by in another school is I have around 50 minutes to go there. Then I come here only 50 minutes. Yeah, it is near from my house. Well, okay, this is the picture, yeah, about my school. So I would like to describe about my school. My school is SMK Muhammadiyah Vocational School with six studies program, right? The first is agency accounting. The second one is office management and business service. It is the last we call this a secretary program, right? This is management business. We call it is a management business. We call this it is a salesman, right? And then the fourth one, visual communication design. And then the fourth is software engineering, especially for software. And then the sixth program is information technology and telecommunication. This one is Syariah banking, right? This is a program that we have in the school. Okay, what is the reason to be a teacher? According to the theory, teacher is a the future. Teacher are the future. They are charmed with teaching young mind and teaching future leaders. An exciting and crucial role in our society, but it can also feel overwhelming to take and discourage. Teachers also help children with education on emotional and social issues, working to help them and develop people as learners. You know, for me, to be a teacher, I know a teacher since I was still children. You know, my father is teaching in the elementary school. So every day I know only the school, right? After I'm coming to university, I know only a teacher in my life. So I will take it the teacher. This is the purpose there. So what is my daily routine and responsibility? My responsibility is I'm homeroom teacher for 29 students. As an English teacher, that I have responsibility to teach more than 24 hours in a week. A professional teacher from Kemendikbud, right? So teacher and school offers talent by applying Pancasila program and culture. Yeah. What is my job and responsibility? My job is as English teacher in here in the school, right? I'm teaching in agency accounting program, office management program, visual communication, and all of the program, I come to the classroom to teach, because I'm in general subject, so I have to teach in all of the program. There are six program in this school, so I teach in this school. So my responsibility is to teach the student in general subject like grammar, intonation, vocabulary, fiction and non-fiction and pronunciation like this. But for vocational subject like I'm teaching about how to handle telephone message, how to handle the guests, how to write, how to use something related to a working area. About the school achievements, In my school achievement is since the last year, well, every years ago, school achievement is A, yeah, in accreditation, and the second is center of excellence in school program design communication visual. It is having excellent school in program in this program. So there's one certificate accurate for accounting, then certificate Cisco for informatic and telecommunication technique, Alphamart class for management business. But for secretary, no achievement. Now, what do you do for the future career as a teacher? For my future in career, maybe I will, after having a large experience teaching in vocational school, maybe next time, if I have ability or not, I will do create a small business like business retail, like small restaurant like this. Maybe I want to create a rental house, yeah, for student. And then maybe I want to making cooperation with Syariah Banking for Umrah and Hajj, for example. Maybe because we have the cafe, maybe I would like to create a studio photographer for wedding organizer, maybe for graduation or business online, etc. Okay, that's enough for my presentation. Yes, Mr. Bobo.
Okay, thank you so much, Alfianti, for your time. You are explaining it very good and very clear. So we're gonna go to the next sessions. The next session is questions and answers. So if anybody have any questions, please raise your hand.
Okay, Mr. Bobo, may I give a suggestion before we come to our question and answer session? Al, would you like to stop screen, please?
All right.
Okay, thank you, Al. Okay, Al. You just push the red one, stop screen.
Stop share, maybe.
Yeah, stop share. Yeah, thank you, Al. Okay, Mr. Bobo, please take your time.
Question and answer, right? Well, so we go to the next session. Question and answer. Am I right? Tell me.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, everybody. If you have any questions, please raise your hand. Anybody have a question to Alfie Yancy?
Of course, yes.
Excuse me, Mr. Bobo and Mr. Helmi.
Yes, Uni Irma.
Yes, I see right now we have newcomer.
Yep.
Maybe we can...
A newcomer, Irna.
Uh-huh.
New Irna is newcomer. You didn't just come. That was what he said.
I'm sorry, last week I can't join you. I couldn't join this part. I see there is Miss Linda and her. Maybe we can she can introduce herself, maybe.
Yeah, okay. Is it okay, Linda? Miss Irna or Nirna wants you to introduce about yourself in a short, and then we can continue to our question and answer session. Is it okay, Nilinda?
Okay.
Okay, take your time.
thank you so much.
Yeah.
So nice to see you all, yeah, my sana, yeah, my relatives from Mage, yeah, from Mage. So I have joined this group 2 days ago, yeah, inviting by Helmi, yeah, Helmi. Thank you so much, yeah, for inviting me. So this is a new one for me because of we are not so active, yeah, in Mage Saondo also because I don't know much, I don't know more many person in Mage actually, yeah. So let me introduce myself. My name is Linda. I live in Condet, yeah, East Jakarta. So I moved from Bukit Tinggi, yeah, in 1992 to Jakarta as a teacher, English teacher, yeah, in senior high school, one of public school, yes, state school in East Jakarta, in South Jakarta. So I teach there for about almost 30 years so old there.
Yeah, wow, it's quite a long time.
So maybe for about 5 years later, I will be retired. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But you look still young.
Oh yeah.
Alhamdulillah.
So nice to see you, Pak Bobo, Uda Yusril, apa lagi nih?
Arman, Yandri,
Matroni, Irma, Taviani, ya. Sejala partisipan ya, only 10 person ya.
Yep.
Anything else that you want to know from me?
Yeah, please anyone, you want to say, you want to ask something to Nilinda? Okay, Arman. Please, Arman.
Hello, Unilinda. Assalamualaikum.
Ya, waalaikumsalam, Arman.
Nice to meet you here.
Nice to meet you too. Yeah.
Where about in Mage are you from?
I'm a small village, yeah. Same is Uda Yusril, Kampung Manau.
Kampung Manau. Kampung Manau. Actually, my father is from Kampung Manau too.
Oh, yeah? Who?
Who is your father? Tell me. Tell us.
If you know my father is Matukang.
The name?
The name? Can you mention his name, Arman?
Alizar. His name is Alizar. People in Kampung used to call him Matukang Malinsati.
Oh iya. Kak Muan ya. Iya ya.
Nah. Ya. Yeah. He's Temuan's brothers. Brother.
Oh iya. Yeah?
So where are you from now in your houses?
So near the Surah Kampung Manau.
Near Musala Kampung Manau.
Ah, iya. Yeah.
Okay.
So, sometimes you meet in Kampung Manau. Sometimes, maybe sometimes.
Okay, Arman. Do you have any question else?
I think that's it. Thank you, Dayani.
You're welcome, Arman. Yandri, our millennials, we haven't seen you for ages, Yandri. We miss you so much.
Thank you.
You have a new friend in Pekanbaru, Elvianti. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
You can meet each other, inshallah.
Yeah. Inshallah.
You wanna have a question to our new member, Unilinda?
Of course, Unilinda.
Yep.
What subject do you teach at your school? English, yeah.
English, I'm English teacher actually. I'm English teacher. I'm graduate from Ikit Padang.
Oh, Ikit Padang.
So this is my sister-in-law, yeah, Aisha. El, yeah. Nice to see you.
Welcome, Unesha.
Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Pak Yusril, Pak Arman, Bu Irma, Nilinda, Pak Bu, Pak Roni, Pak Oktiendri, ada Dr. Asrizal juga.
Ya, welcome back, Uni.
I'm sorry, I don't activate the video because on the way.
Yeah, it's okay, Uni. It's okay, never mind. Take your time.
Thank you.
So right now we have a question and answer session due to our newcomers, Uni Linda. So every participant here want to know more about Uni Linda.
Suggestion, yeah.
Yeah.
Suggestion from L.
Okay. What time did you enter Ikit Padang, Uni Linda?
In 1986, so I graduated from 1990.
Oh, yeah, so you are my older sister senior in Ikit Padang maybe because my elder sister entered Ikit Padang in 1967. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
My older sister is your junior maybe.
Oh. Yeah. So you might let you introduce yourself to me.
So I must introduce myself to you.
Of course, absolutely.
Especially for Uni Linda, yeah.
Yep. This is a special, you know, guest tonight.
Yes. Yeah. My name is Irna. Not Irma, but Irna.
Yeah.
I'm from Kubang, Pinang Baliri, Kubang. Mm-hmm. Right now, I stayed in Bogor. I'm living in Bogor since 1992 because I'm study in IPB. And until now, I still stay in Bogor.
Oh, yeah. Good news. Merantau.
Perantau. Okay, thank you, Nilinda.
You're welcome.
Anyone else? Mr. Bobo, do we have any question to Nilinda?
Well, I'm afraid not. I don't have any.
Okay, you may ask.
Actually, I have one question.
Okay, take your time.
You know, behind you there is a beautiful flowers. Uh-huh. What is that?
Oh, you're not wondering about the background.
It's just so nice. Yeah, beautiful okay. Background.
This simple question.
I think in Holland, is it?
No, in Japan.
Oh, in Japan.
Yeah. Oh, is there in Japan?
Yeah, this is
looks so pretty.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because I don't have the picture, I just remind I don't have the picture of Magi, so just
That picture is better. it's so
I like
nice.
The flowers, what the name of the flowers, Uni? I forgot it.
Oh yeah, sorry, pardon me.
Sakura
flowers or what?
Sakura,
right? Mm-hmm. Oh, I see, this famous flower from Japan.
Just to hide, my walls, my green walls.
That's it's look it. So, you know, cool.
I want to have background like that, but I don't know how to do it.
Okay, maybe Uni Irna will inform you and give you a tutorial how to make your background later on, Bobo.
Exactly, you can teach me how to.
Yeah, it's quite easy.
The expert is Yandri, I think.
Yeah.
Okay. So the new one, the younger one,
Yandri is very good with a computer.
You know, Nilinda, Yandri is an IT teacher in Pekanbaru also.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Which
Yandri?
One?
Tell me about yourself. Yeah. Maybe Unile want to know more about you. Would you like to introduce about yourself in short, please?
Oh yeah, thank you, Mr. Helmi.
Yep.
I'm Yandri. I also teacher at primary school. I teach a computer in Pekanbaru.
Oh, so many friends from Pekanbaru, yeah?
Yeah. Dr. Asrizal also from Pekanbaru, and also Ardi, and then, yeah.
LVNT.
Sometime Uda usually move to Pekanbaru, Bamarmi also, yeah? So many participants or members of MSTV English Club are from Pekanbaru. Inshallah, on February, I'll be there, Yandri, and I'll meet you, inshallah.
Inshallah.
Yep. Anyone else?
Oh, Octaviandri.
Octaviandri.
Octaviandri. How old are you now? Still young?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It looks like too young.
How old are you now? We didn't ask you, Yandri.
40.
40?
Oh. 40. That's not young enough.
Yeah.
That's really young. Young.
Look so young, but not that young.
Yep, look so young.
So, Elfie, I want to ask you, how many teachers all in your school?
In my school, 60 teachers.
Yeah, for 1,000 students. Yeah, for 1,000 students.
Yeah, 1,000 students. Right. It's including employee 70 or. And employees, so 70, yeah.
So, what about the state school, yeah? Compare with your school, Muhammadiyah school and state school. Is the student from your school is larger than the state school?
Pardon me?
It means that the student of your school is larger than the state school, like Al-Azhar, yeah? They have so many students, yeah, rather than the state school, rather than my school, actually. What about in your school, in Pekanbaru?
Yeah.
So, Muhammadiyah is have the many students rather than the state school.
Yeah.
You mean United States?
Muhammadiyah school have after nation school, yeah, and then the second one usually we have Muhammadiyah is will be the private school is will be the second one beside the nation school after nation school.
So amazing,
but it is a different. Mm-hmm. But it is different from Yogyakarta. But yeah. In Yogyakarta, maybe they will take Muhammadiyah is the first one. The second one we say will be the national school. Because you know, Muhammadiyah is coming from Yogyakarta. It is the first.
Oh yeah, I see. Yeah. Yeah. It's good, yeah, because of the mention, yeah, the mention school.
Yeah.
So it's amazing, yeah, for me that mention school is get the many student, yeah, rather than the government school or state school, yeah.
In Muhammadiyah, you know, because we have some the good leader, yeah, will be managed by the leader from UIN, right? Even in wilayah Riau, yeah. We get the leader from UIN, and then in the pusat, yeah, in the central, we have in the Jakarta, like in PP Muhammadiyah in Menteng Raya, yeah, number 62 in Jakarta. This is the leader of Muhammadiyah is a. Haidar Nasir from Gajah Mada right now, right? Before that is Din Samsudin is from professor from UIN Jakarta, right? So because management is a good in management, so maybe the just that he maybe believe for that. Maybe the government also have a belief meant to the Muhammadiyah. So in this year, we have the helping from the Dirjen Vokasi. We have around to development of the cafe, the cafe program, so the like management, multimedia. But right now it's the cafe. We have around we have development of the building and the machine for this create this program. We have around 1.8 billion this year. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So the government believe for this. Yeah. So we can do the best only.
It's right. That good news for me and the new interesting for me. Yeah. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Okay, Al, can I have some question, please? Based on your explanation about your school.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
My first question is, what makes your school unique and different if we compare with another vocational school among in Pekanbaru?
The first time I'm coming to this school, we have only three major program, secretary, accountant, and pemasaran. This kind of business school, SMIA, that's all, SMIA. The old name is SMIA, right? Mm-hmm. But after several years, we have a combine between technique and business. Business and technique. Because we are we have an idea in religion, we have to improve our student, our mindset of student, as a teacher training by Muhammadiyah is different. The teacher, we have a special training, and for the headmaster is the special training, a different training, and the vice of headmaster different special training. To survive, we survive in development school. I forget we have get up around 3 o'clock, 3 o'clock mm-hmm. in the morning.
Yep.
We are reading Al Quran, and then we are praying together, and then we have we had to do training something. We have around 2 weeks of the teacher like this. So we have some idealists in our attitude. After we are combined between business and technology, like telecommunication, multimedia, and then another program like software engineering. We are combined all of the program we are entertain to the society. And then after that, everyone know about our school in Pekanbaru. So it is the location. The location also is the important thing.
Mm-hmm.
We can all every side of Pekanbaru, everyone can go there. Side, we are in location in a central city,
mm-hmm.
Is it right? Okay. After we have by technology, we do things very easy. We are giving examination and giving the lesson to the student is very easy by using technology. Mm-hmm. So everything is easy, right? So we have how much student we can arrange it. How many student we can arrange. So if the student is more the student, we need to have for more building, yeah, more classes to have it. And then we, so we until now we have 40 classes is available. Yeah, so we need a 1,500 maybe. We can take the student 1,500 maybe. Mm-hmm. But okay. Now we have only 1,000 students.
Wow, it's good, Al. So my last question, Al. As a private school, of course, we have to give a service excellence to our student and also to parents, right? So may I know what kind of your school service excellence itself? Can you tell us?
Yeah, to have the parents, all of our activities we done in the school, we have a communication to the other parents.
Yep.
Whatever if their parents don't agree with the was program, mm-hmm. the parent agree with what we are do, we can do. Mm-hmm. So almost all can agree what we do. So we don't we talk it clearly. Yeah.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I think.
Okay, thank you, Al. Maybe another participant want to give a question related to your presentation, please. Thank you.
Okay.
Unirna. Yep.
Yeah, Unirna.
Okay. Okay. Unir and to No. Usually in Muhammadiyah school, they always give the content, the local content for the lesson. It is AIK, Al-Islam Kemuhammadiyahan.
Yes,
that's right. Is it in your school? There is the local content like that?
Yes, that's right. Muhammadiyah. Yeah, Muhammadiyah in bahasa Arab ya. It is a special thing for Muhammadiyah school, right? Besides we are giving general lesson, right? By using the student can be by tahfiz, maybe write them about Al-Quran, maybe sholat jenazah, and then sholat berjamaah, right? All of the Al-Quran, the student learn it, how to speak, how to make we be imam in prayer, yeah? All of thing the student must study about it. So after that, you know, in my school, before we are beginning to study at 7:45, right? So the student have to come to the school 7:10, and then all of the student in the classroom they have reading Al-Quran, reading Al-Quran until the end. After the end, maybe they are khatam in this. So we are together in the class like this. And then the student will be the leader, ERM, yeah. ERM. Maybe they choose one will be as a cadre, maybe as a like a quorum like this. So they are getting together with the same like we know the senior school like OSIS, right? But they are ERM. But another extracurricular, they have bela diri, right? Bela diri.
Strong
Tapak Suci.
Tapak Suci.
Yeah, they will the strong one after getting Yeah, after war, yeah, they are learning, they are tapak suci, running, and then like this.
How about Pramuka? Is it Hizbul Watan in your school?
Yes, yes, Hizbul Watan. It is a special teacher for this, and then the teacher is don't have any other job, yeah, only Hizbul Watan. Almost all of the students, we have like to join Hizbul Watan. They join, yeah. They are making camp and another like this.
Yeah, it is the specific program for Muhammadiyah, the Muhammadiyah School, from early childhood education until university. So always there is AIKA, Al Islam Kemuhammadiyahan, gitu ya.
Yeah. Yeah, so in Muhammadiyah, like in kindergarten, elementary school, junior school, senior school, or vocational school, and until university. We can graduate after we are adult and we have teachers in Muhammadiyah, right?
Okay, thank you very much.
Yeah, you're welcome, Erna.
Uda Yusril, do you have any question to AL or something else?
Oh, yes. Actually, I have present before the other asked the question.
Okay.
Okay. I've seen that your presentation is good presentation. So, but my question actually also same with how many questions before. What is the unique of your school? But for me, there is not a unique right now. So because there are some your program or like computer and also accounting, communication technology and photograph. And the program also give in another what we call another senior high school. But in my mind, the unique program in Riau right now should be a biotechnology. You know that biotechnology, as we know before, Riau, the famous from Riau is crude oil that from earth or from underground. But right now, the famous from Riau is palm oil. Why senior high school or like senior
vocational school?
Vocational school.
Yep.
Don't have biotechnology. How to make some product from palm oil?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that the unique, I think. That hope from me.
Yeah. I think it's a good suggestion from Uda Yusril Al. Maybe you can discuss with your leader and then have a special program in biotechnology. Inshallah, yeah. So what do you think, Al, about this Uda Yusril suggestion? Do you agree or disagree?
Biotechnology, it is a, what is the next, we do next? What is the function of biotechnology? I don't know, it is a...
Biotechnology, especially in palm oil. How to have some product come from palm oil? You know, from minyak sawit.
Yeah, minyak sawit.
We can have some product from minyak sawit or from palm oil. Yeah, as we know that crude oil before the oil come from the underground.
Soil.
Right now, Riau is produce oil from the top. From the what do we call that? From the land. So this in Malaysia, I know that we have some children studying in Malaysia biotechnology.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have like a early real son. If I have not made mistake, three of his son studying about biotechnology in Malaysia.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So why in PO not create this program?
Yep.
Yeah.
A good program, I think.
Yeah, good suggestion, Uda Yusril.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, Uda Yusril. Maybe the leader from Muhammadiyah, yeah. For this is the depend on human resourcing, yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe in Muhammadiyah, you know, all of the society applying something what they have. Muhammadiyah have a facility, right? Someone applying about pharmacies, for example. Muhammadiyah giving facilities for that. Maybe human resources having economic mastering, for example. Muhammadiyah giving facilities, and then maybe human resources giving kedokteran like this. The Muhammadiyah giving facilities, but until now. We still have the human resources like ability to have the program. Yes,
inshallah, next time, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I believe that we have some resources about biotechnology. Or there are so many people, our people in a foreign state because of. Our government don't give the opportunity to them. So why? Maybe you can create this, you and your team or your, what do we call that? create the program, I think.
Mm-hmm.
I hope Ariel should the pioneer of this program.
Yeah. Inshallah.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much, El. Yeah. Thank you, El.
Yeah.
You are welcome, Uda Yusril. So this is a good recommendation. Maybe El can discuss with his team later on, El. Inshallah, yeah?
Yeah, inshallah.
Okay. Well, everyone, still have any question due to El presentation? Arman, do you have any question, Arman?
Yes, Uda Helmi.
Okay, please take your time.
Uni Elvi, assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Earlier you mentioned about the Muhammadiyah. As we know that Muhammadiyah is one of the largest Islamic organization in Indonesia, yeah. And it has so many schools, university, hospital. Orphanage house and etc. Do you involve in the organizations itself, or just being a teacher in the
school?
Muhammadiyah schools.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Arman. You know, before we have become maybe because this it is you know yayasan ya tetap ya because we have before maybe we have 1 year, 2 years or 3 years to honor in Muhammadiyah. So we have we feel it is we have a suitable with my our confident we have we feel sweet for us to work in Muhammadiyah. So we need to have the member of organization Muhammadiyah first. After we have the member of Muhammadiyah organization, we have to apply. We have to apply to Yogyakarta to have a cut of member of Muhammadiyah. After that, we have to take the special test to be the teacher of Muhammadiyah. So after that, we have we will be the one of the member of Muhammadiyah. Maybe we can join in Asia. We can be the national Asia. So what is activity we can join it? Called the leader from Jakarta, the leader from. In the central, yeah, okay. Di PP Muhammadiyah, yeah, in Jakarta, Profesor Din Samsudin, Profesor Haider Nasir, like this, Profesor, we are in Pekanbaru now because we have the member of Muhammadiyah, and we are going to Gedung Dakwah to have a training about religion. Yeah, we have we are getting together in the mosque. Yeah. Then mosque or some, we have a tablik and every month we have a tablik akbar, and then no Muhammadiyah we without ceramah, yeah. We know we have a ceramah all the time, and then in the classroom the student will be must be giving a speech. Yeah. We will even though it is a short speech. Yeah, maybe they must be someone like Tafis. Yeah, maybe they are good to be an imam in the prayer like this. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Another, wow. Because I was once in Muhammadiyah school as well, Pesantren Muhammadiyah in Garut.
Yeah, Arman. Mm-hmm. So you know when I was going to Jakarta, like now I'm going to Pintu Senayan, Kemendikbud. So I get the hotel in beside Otam Nahabang over there, and then I see Muhammadiyah school there. You know, but the beside Otam Nahabang there. Oh, it is our school Muhammadiyah. So coming to Jakarta, it is come from. Yeah, I'm not so strange anymore to look at Muhammadiyah. Yeah. So we because feel every 5 years we are going to around the Indonesia. Maybe we can Sulawesi or Kalimantan or Jawa like the. Sumatra, like Muktamar Muhammadiyah, we can travel together.
Yeah, it's good for you.
Okay, thank you, Arman.
Welcome, everyone. Thank you.
Our time is right now is 9:21. We still have one question before we close our weekly Zoom meeting tonight. If we still have a question, we give it time. Uni Aisha, do you have any question to El Uni?
Thank you, Pak Helmi. Yep. Actually, okay, I don't have a question, but maybe a comment.
Yeah, okay, please take a time, Uni.
Yeah, for what do I call her? Ibu or sister? Sister Elvianti.
Sister Elvianti. Okay.
Okay, this congratulations is a very nice presentation about your school. And then you give us a view about the Muhammadiyah school and then your activity. I hope that you will be enjoyed. I think this as a teacher, we are enjoyed at our profession, right? That's and we are still feel young because every year we meet the young people, the new students.
That's right.
And then finally after years and we find ourselves getting old, but
still look young.
Still young.
It's one of the benefits being a teacher, or being a lecturer, right?
Yeah, Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
So congratulations. Thank you for your presentation. It's very nice, Sister Elviani. That's it, Pak Yusri, Pak Helmi. Thank you very much for opportunity.
Okay, you're welcome, Muni. Yeah, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Okay, Mr. Bobo, we come to the end of our program. Please take your time, Mr. Bobo.
Okay, everybody. Time goes by so quickly. And Elfianti, thank you so much for your presentation. It was so great. And to be honest, I don't know much about school. And now I know a little bit. So many knowledge I have in here. Well, it's time for us to say goodbye to each other. And well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your participation and cooperation during this event. And let's say hamdallah.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah.
Before we end our program. So goodbye and thanks so much everybody for attending our meeting tonight.
Okay.
Have a great day. Good night, everybody.